it is going to be sensational from the Joe Louis Arena.
I tell you what an opportunity to see this tremendous pay-per-view event. Calling your cable system, my friends, Joe Louis Arena going to be on fire when the monster trucks meet, as you said, crunching each other on the floor of the Joe Louis Arena.
The Pit Bull Sergeant Craig Pittman in this next match here on WCW Saturday Night. Let me let you know, fans, we still have not heard from Johnny B. Bad. Sting says, well, it's okay, we got about a little bit more than an hour left in this program.
Yes.
He'll wait. He wants to wrestle Johnny B. Bad, and Johnny B. Bad earned it at Fall Brawl. It's incredible what's happened here this week.
This is something exciting. I said, you know, coming on here, my first show on WCW Saturday Night, that's going to be exciting. But my friend, I never even knew what was going to happen. And the bottom line on this thing right here, Sting is going to wait. And I hope we get it, brother. We got an hour or so left.
That's right. All right. Here's the Morse code.
Yes.
The Pitbull Sergeant Craig Pittman waiting on his opponent. And the man who, special ops agent from the CIA, he is from Langley, Virginia. He was a much different soldier than the Pitbull Sergeant Craig Pittman when they all went out on this special mission. And it's been a deep animosity driven into both men since then.
Well, I'll tell you what, this guy was an organizer, where the Pitbull Pittman was an agonizer.
That's right.
Two different people, friends.
Yeah.
Children.
All right. We talked about Fall Brawl. As a matter of fact, it was at Fall Brawl, if you'll recall, when from the ceiling, the Pit Bull rappelled and the sneak attack on Cobra, and he got the quick win over Cobra on the Fall Brawl pay-per-view. But then last week on WCW Saturday Night, it was a sneak attack of his own by Cobra from behind, and he got the win on the Pit Bull Sergeant Craig Pittman, and these two men will go at it one more time.
Well, I tell you what, they both possess that ability to get in there and do some sneaking attacking, but bottom line right now, they are face-to-face right here. We got it on WCW Saturday Night. Lock them up. Let's do it, brother. They're going to get down and slobber knocking right here.
Slobber knocking, huh?
Slobber knocking.
Well, there you go. There's another one.
We've
heard flubbering. We've heard slobber knocking.
Flubbering.
And it's only the first week. And the Pit Bull, you know, this is the first time, I think, here on Saturday Night that they've met each other head-on. And the Pit Bull looking to try to tip the balance towards his way.
Well, he got it twisted around right there. Right away, he went for that arm, trying to get him in a position to get that code red. We know the power and the velocity that he puts that on. And right here, Cobra has turned it around. Nice move right there.
Great wrestling maneuver. Cobra down on it. And this is why WCW is number one in the world in wrestling. It's because we have the greatest wrestlers in the world in the ring. You see them on Saturday Night. You're going to see them coming up on Monday Night. You're on TNT when Luger battles the Macho Man for the first time ever. When Flair battles Arn Anderson live from Denver, Colorado.
Oh, boy. Whoa, almost lost it there. I'll pick it up. That's the truth. I'll tell you what. Arn Anderson, Nature Boy, Ric Flair. The bottom line with the Savage thing with Luger, Luger said, went on record in this past Nitro, and when he said on Monday night, I will leave the town. I will leave WCW. No. But I'll be
You're right. And it'll happen this Monday live on TNT.
What are you saying? It'll happen? You predicting that he will leave? That he will leave?
No, I said the match will happen. There was a battering ram by the Pit Bull Craig Pittman. I'm not going to let you say any more on that. You're not going to put some heat on me.
No, I didn't.
Although you've been trying to all telecast.
I try to just give your opinion a little bit. I want to bring that out.
Look at this move. Pulling on the neck. I know Hulk Hogan remembers that move as the Giant had those massive arms around him at Fall Brawl.
Hey, the Giant put Luger to rest, put Savage to rest,
and Alex
put Wonder Kid to rest, and a whole host of others on Monday Nitro just passed, and I guarantee you, he really showed me something. I didn't know what he had, my friend, but if Giants is in his genes, if you will, he is quicker, faster, and maybe meaner than the original version, my friend.
Wow.
And that's my opinion.
And that was a mean one.
Yes, and a close friend of mine.
Yes. Oh, forearm shot to the head. Cobra reels back to a neutral corner, and are making Pittman reels back. Cobra sends him into the other side. Cobra, boy, Cobra just wants to punish him here. Look, a right hand, side of the head. He's up on top, and Cobra pounding away on the Pit Bull, who wraps him up. One, two, three, and he beats him.
Boy, that was close. I'll tell you what, Cobra made a mistake, though, right there, my friend.
And what was that?
I'll tell you right after this announcer gets out of my way.
Okay.
All right, the bottom line is right here. As he took him up in that situation where he didn't want to do it, started banging on his head, you'll see Cobra reach underneath and grab them tights, got him in a vulnerable situation, and got the win over Cobra, his arch enemy.
Coming to Saturday night very soon in action, the man of a thousand moves, Dean Malenko. Here's up close and personal with him.